Hey there, I'm Harrison Adell, Vice President of Animal Operations and Welfare here at Dallas Zoo, and I'm at the Savannah today to make a big announcement. It's been a really exciting week at the Savannah because we've had a baby, and it's a boy. Katie the giraffe gave birth to a calf earlier this week. He had his well baby check, and he's a healthy 150 pounds and about 5 feet 11 inches, so it's a big baby. And this is Katie's third calf here. Dad, Tobogo, is also a member of the herd. You've probably met him at the feeding deck here at the Giants of the Savannah. And we're going to give mom and the calf about 2 weeks or so off exhibit to bond and spend time together before we gradually introduce the calf and mom back to the exhibit. We'll be keeping everybody informed via Facebook pages so that people can come out and meet that calf when he's ready to meet his adoring fans. Being that this isn't Katie's first calf, she knows exactly what she's doing. The labor went very smoothly, took less than an hour for her to give birth to this bouncing baby boy. Keepers have been monitoring the last couple months or so as she got closer to birth. It is a 12 to 14 month gestation, so it's a long, long pregnancy. But in the last couple of weeks or so, Katie's been spending more time in the barn, in a stall that we designed specifically for healthy births, with some nice soft sand to cradle the baby when it was born. The maternity stall in the barn gives mom and calf some privacy, so that they can bond to one another. But the barrier between the maternity stall and the stalls next door is a pretty low one, so the rest of the herd can see and smell and understand what mom and calf are doing. It makes it easier for us to introduce the calf to other giraffes when they've all seen and smelled one another ahead of time. And we have a couple of giraffes, including Augie, who's one of our older males, who've met lots of calves in the past. Augie is a great uncle figure, so we'll introduce mom and calf to Augie and a couple of the female giraffes first before we bring the giraffes back out to the exhibit. And keepers have been monitoring overnight using closed-circuit cameras. It allows us to keep tabs on the youngster and on mom's behavior without being in their way or disturbing in any way. One of the first questions I know we'll get is what the baby's name is, and we honestly don't know yet. We haven't picked a name yet. So as soon as we have a name for the calf, we'll announce it on social media. The birth of any giraffe is important. Giraffes are not doing all that well in the wild. Dallas Zoo is partnered with Giraffe Conservation Foundation. It's a great organization that does field work to help support giraffe populations in Africa, where populations have declined from about 140,000 giraffes in the 90s down to only 80,000 giraffes now. As an organization that tries to connect people with wildlife, we hope that when people come out and meet this little calf, they'll be motivated to learn more about giraffe conservation. We can't wait to introduce our guests and members and visitors to this little giraffe calf once he's ready to come out and meet them. In the meantime, you can certainly come and meet Tobogo Dad here in the giraffe yard or in the Giants of the Savannah. As soon as we're ready to introduce this little one to his adoring fans, we'll announce that on social media. So keep an eye out on our Facebook page. Thanks so much. We'll see you soon.